ever have a whale stick out its tongue at you? Stay tuned.
Let me try. The operator, she wants to make a collect call to Paris, France. No, not Paris, Texas. Paris, France. The one in Europe.
My dad wants to make phone call.
You know, over the Atlantic.
Hi.
Hi, we'll try back later. Thank you.
David, come on.
Hey. What did you say?
My dog wants to make a phone call.
Is that supposed to be some kind of joke?
Yeah, a very bad one.
A very bad one.
Yeah, I was trying to get your attention.
Yeah,
you know?
It worked.
Come on, Ripper has to make a phone call.
Is that a joke?
No.
No, Ripper could actually make a phone call. She could talk, you know?
David, I've got news for you. If that dog could talk, she probably wouldn't have much to say.
No, Ripper understand language. Watch. Ripper? Run over, Ripper. Run over. You see?
So?
David, many dogs can do that.
But Ripper is very special. She's almost like a person. Let me show you. Ripper, ready? Mets-toi sur le dos. Retourne-toi. You see, she understands English and French.
David, Ripper is reacting to your signal.
What signal?
The signal you're filming with your fingers, as you said to roll over.
Okay, I will put my hands behind my back. Ready? Ready, Ripper? Roll over, Ripper. Roll over. Please, roll over, Ripper. Mets-toi sur le dos. Mets-toi sur le dos. Please.
This is really pitiful.
David, the dog understood your signal, not your words.
Mets-toi sur le dos. Retourne-toi. Mets-toi sur le dos. Ripper. Please, Ripper.
I'm at SeaWorld in San Diego, California, looking for trainer Chuck Tompkins. There he is. But what's he doing?
You know, you look really funny making all these gestures. What does that all mean?
I was communicating with my friend.
With this beautiful animal?
That Shamu the killer whale.
Well, how do you communicate?
Well, just like you and I communicate by talking with one another, I have to communicate in different ways with Shamu. And the way that you just saw me communicate was through hand signals and body language.
Oh, so all those gestures were really signals.
That's right. What I have is a specific signal that I give Shamu, and he knows to do a specific behavior on that hand signal. For example, all I have to do is move my hand side to side, and Shamu knows to move his head side to side.
Oh, so when you go like this, Shamu responds and does a specific behavior.
No, see, we have to be very careful. You weren't being very specific. Your hand was flat. My finger was out, and I was moving it side by side. Now watch as I move my head up and down.
Oh, he nods his head up and down.
That's right. Now what's he do?
He's waving his fin.
That's right. So Shamu's watching me very, very closely. He knows that each hand signal I'm giving him has a specific behavior.
Well, it's really incredible that you can communicate. I mean, he's on the other side of that glass wall in the water. How does he see us?
Well, Shamu has excellent eyesight. His eyes are designed for his environment because he needs to not only see out of the water, but in the water. In his natural environment, killer whales are top predators. They eat anything and everything found in the open ocean. Polar bears, penguins, sea lions, larger whales. So they have to have that good eyesight to be able to spot these animals on beaches, ice floes, and maybe far out in the ocean.
Well, how do you get Shamu to learn which response goes with which signal.
We call that approximation training. And all that simply means is we take a very difficult behavior and break it down into very small steps. Let's say I want to teach Shamu to raise his flipper. What I would do is touch his flipper, and as soon as Shamu started to raise his flipper, I would tell him, good boy. Now, what I'd eventually do is I would touch his flipper, raise my hand. And after, through that association of the actual signal of touching the flipper and raising my arm, Shamu would start pairing that signal with that particular response.
So after a while, the whale would just respond to the hand signal and not need the touch too.
That's right. Shamu would know that as soon as I lift my arm, that would be his signal to raise his pectoral flipper. Now, during that approximation training, we can reinforce the animal in a variety of different ways. Remember I said, tell Shamu he's a good boy? Well, there's all sorts of different ways that we can tell Shamu he's doing a good job. We can do it through rubbing the animal down. We can feed him sometimes. We can play with him. We can jump in and give him play toys. But the thing that he really enjoys the most is us rubbing him down and playing with him. He likes to have us play with him and scratch his back.
Well, are there any other ways of communicating besides hand signals and touch?
Well, we did hand signals and body language. We also use touch, and we use touch when we're swimming with the animal and right next to him. We can rub him down or we can touch a certain part of his body, and he knows to move in a particular direction. We can also use sounds. Now, killer whales use sounds in their natural environment to communicate. Just like you and I talk through our sounds, killer whales communicate through their sounds. They have a wide range of communication through these bleeps and bloops of sounds that they're capable of making. I've got to get ready for the presentation. If you could do me one favor, during the show, make sure you watch and listen and watch the signals and watch the responses. But just before I go, Shamu, there's one more thing.
Did you see any of the signals? Let's replay the show, and I'll point them out to you. Here's the first one. When the trainer's 2 feet touch the whale's nose, that's the signal to jump out of the water. The trainer slaps the water, and the whale responds by jumping over him. This signal is done out of the water. It means go around the pool and jump. Here are 4 signals. Stay up and shake your flippers. Stop, but stay up. Nod your head. And here's the reward. Good boy. Sometimes the whale just imitates the trainer. The trainer walking tells the whale to keep turning. Touching the flipper means to keep going, but grabbing the flipper means stop. Finally, do as I do. In that show, the whales responded to signals they can see and feel. Now watch and listen as the whales respond to signals they can hear. That tone is the first signal and tells them to start the show. Listen for the other signals.
And now, a word from... Thank you.
This is the United States. The next film takes place here, in France.
Chantal, it's me, Mary Lopez.
Hi, where are you?
I'm in Biarritz. I've just arrived.
Oh, great. Do you want to see me?
Of course I do.
Okay, press over the green button.
Okay. I can see you.
Yes.
Oh, my God.
You too.
You're kidding.
No, I'm not.
This is...
phone.
This is incredible.
It is, isn't it?
Gosh, what a surprise.
If you want to find out more about it, we can go see my friend Guy. He's a specialist.
Oh, great. I have a lot of questions.
Okay, so why don't we meet in half an hour?
Okay, I'll come to your house.
Great.
Bye-bye. Mary Lopez, this is Guy Mondorge. He's a visiophone specialist, so he can tell you everything you want to know about the visiophone.
Oh, that's wonderful, because I have a lot of questions.
On peut appeler quelqu'un?
Peut-être, on appelle Malek.
What?
Ah, oh, you dial tones.
And then you dial the number.
Just like a regular phone?
Just like a regular phone.
And up here, it's typed out, I see.
The number appears on the screen.
Oh, great.
Allô, oui?
Allô, Malek?
Oui, bonjour.
Allô, c'est Chantal.
Salut, Chantal.
Je t'appelle pour montrer le visiophone à mon amie Marie Lopez qui est là.
Ah, très bien.
Alors, je vais appuyer sur le bouton image pour qu'on te voit.
D'accord.
We're gonna see him now. We're gonna press on this button.
Uh-huh. Oh, there he is. Well, how can he see us? How can we see him?
Elle veut savoir comment on fait pour le voir. Comment ça se fait qu'on le voit?
Comment on le voit? Ben, on le voit parce que là-dedans, il y a aussi une caméra. Cette caméra, elle est ici. Quand on se trouve en face de la caméra, ça nous permet de nous voir.
The camera is here.
Uh-huh.
Okay. So if we take the camera
out. You can take it out.
Ben, là, on peut la sortir.
Ah, bonjour, Marie.
Bonjour, Malek. Bonjour.
Hello.
Now he sees you. Now he sees you. Well, so?
Can he see us?
He can see us. Of course he can see us, because he can see you. Because you're in front of the camera.
Si tu veux voir l'image que tu lui envoies, tu appuies sur la touche control.
If you want to see yourself, you press on this button. Go ahead. Press. And if you want to see him again, you have to just push that same button.
Oh, and there's Malek. Ah.
Yeah.
That's really interesting.
But in order for you to see him or him to see you, both of you have to press on the image button.
Oh, so one person can't see the other
right,
without
the
other.
Right, it's a two-way system.
Ah, so that way if you, like, come out of the shower to grab the phone.
Right.
You know, they can have some control. Merci, Malek.
Au revoir.
Au revoir.
Au revoir.
The Visiophone is not just a regular telephone with a TV camera and screen attached. All the information, both the picture and sound information, is carried under the streets, not through wires, but through glass fibers. These fibers are carefully made of very pure glass, and they can carry much more information than copper wires used in ordinary phones. In a factory where the glass fibers are made, thick glass tubes are heated and pulled into long, thin glass fibers. One 4-foot glass tube can be pulled like taffy into a fiber that's miles long. The sound and picture information is communicated with light pulses. These pulses are signals that travel through the glass fibers. The light signals bounce around the inside walls of the fibers, traveling long distances, even turning corners. Imagine, a single glass fiber, not much thicker than a human hair, can carry all the sound and picture information in both directions at the same time, even in color.
Hi, Chantal. I just wanted to say goodbye before I left and use the Visiophone one more time.
Oh, that's so nice. You're really good at using the Visiophone now.
Yeah, now I know everything. So thanks for everything, okay?
You're welcome.
Take care.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
An ex-tennis pro named Flash Jordan hires the gang to track down a white limousine with a bald-headed driver, but he gives them a phony address.
Mr. Flash Jordan is playing us for chumps.
In fact, his whole story is as fishy as the license plate that reads H. Whale.
Nothing? Well, thanks anyway. I'm really striking out. There's no H. Whale in the phone book. And the people at Motor Vehicles have no record.
Must be an out-of-state license.
Do Mr. Bloodhound's files show an ex-con named Flash Jordan or whatever his name is? Did you check aliases?
And came up zilch.
Can you get a readout on escaped convicts?
I'll check. If Mr. Bloodhound entered it, I can get it out.
How would you like a description of the guy in the white limo?
I'd be delirious.
He has a neck like a bull, wears a size 20 collar, and his sleeves are 35 inches long.
But does he have a shaved head?
Yeah, he weighs about 235 pounds, plenty of muscle.
How'd you get his measurements?
He has his shirts custom made. He went to pick them up when we saw him drive away.
Size 20 collar, 235 pounds? Mr. Whale is really a big fish.
Whales are not fish, they're mammals.
He sounds like a wrestler. Maybe we should check the gyms.
I already have a line on him. His name is not H. Whale. That must mean something else.
Well, then who are we looking for?
Last name Richard, first name Mo, middle initial B. That was the moniker he left at the shirt shop. And he lives at the Essex Hotel.
Nice going, Ricardo.
Here's your list on escaped convicts. Take your pick.
Well, maybe we can narrow it down. Jordan had a real jailhouse complexion, remember?
How about George A. Habler? Broke out of jail 3 days ago.
Alias New Orleans Kid. Can you bring up his record?
Years old, stands 5 feet 10 inches high, weighs about 150 pounds, hair blonde, eyes blue, and he's a nail biter.
Sounds like our client, Mr. Flash Jordan.
He was sent up for 12 years in grand theft for the gold bug caper. Hijacked a security truck and made away with $200,000 in gold bars. Never recovered.
Bloodhound Detective Agency, whenever there's trouble, we're there on the double. Mr. Bloodhound isn't here.
Oh, yes, Mr. Jordan. No, we haven't spotted the white car yet. Where did you say you were staying? Well, can you give us a number where we can reach you? You'll call us. But, sir, it would be better if... Pretty cagey. Our client is pulling a hide-and-seek act.
I heard. He'll call us?
I'll let the police know that we think Flash Jordan, alias the New Orleans Kid, is in town.
Well, we'd better get to size 20 collar before he does. No telling what Flash has in mind. I'll meet you at the Essex Hotel.
Right.
What did he say size 20's collar's name was?
Mo B. Richard.
I think I saw Mo while screening aliases.
Work on it. Hello, police?
That big fish got away. Checked out 3 days ago.
3 days ago? That's when Flash busted out of prison.
No forwarding address. The desk clerk spotted him coming out of the Melville Arms.
That's just a few blocks across town. Let's go.
Save your legs. I just called the Melville.
Checked out?
Yesterday. After half a day.
No forwarding address, huh?
No, that big guy's running scared.
Say he read that Flash busted out of jail.
And knows Flash is out to get him?
Right.
He could be holed up anywhere. That blue book.
What blue book?
The desk clerk says the whale carries a book under his arm like a pet poodle.
What would you guys do without me?
Spill it.
Moby Richards is an ex-wrestler. He used to bill himself as the Human Whale.
His license, H. Whale.
He's also an ex-con. Hijacked a security truck.
Gold bug caper with Flash Jordan?
None other. They were both penned up for 12 years, but the Human Whale got out 5 weeks ago on good behavior.
And Flash busted out in a hurry.
The loot was never recovered, was it? All that gold. But I bet you the Human Whale has got his hands on it, and that's why Flash is after him.
Right!
We've got to get to him first.
Well, he certainly seems to like this neighborhood, doesn't he? Let's get a map of the city and start telephoning hotels.
One Contact is a production of the Children's Television Workshop and FR3.
Thank you.